Good afternoon. This is Kiran Chatterjee from India. Today I will talk about our recent contribution in the domain of capture recapture modeling. And Dr. Pujanito Bhuiya from Imperial College London is my co-author in this paper. So let us start at first. We all know about the importance of census for every federal government, and it is any kind of group of individuals, we need to count them for planning and formation purpose or policies purpose. So broadly, the count of true population size is a very important problem in the domain of social science, medical science, and etc. So capture recapture service actually helps us in this domain specifically to estimate the population size when the population actually is very large or very hard to count. So besides the above domain, these capture recapture methods also have application in the to estimate the population size in the domain of epidemiology, demography, criminology, marketing, and ecology. So let us start by, we have to first understand what is capture-recapture techniques. And for this, we consider two sources. Suppose this is one source, which is they attempted to count this whole population. And another source also attempted to count the population. So there are some people who are counted by both the list, and obviously there may be some of people which are not counted by either the list. So these people actually makes the population totally not known to us. So these people, counting of these people is denoted by X naught naught, which is actually unobserved, unknown, and this value makes my population size, capital N, unknown. So let us say how to estimate the population size using this data. So assuming least independence assumption along with the close population and homogeneity assumption of the individuals, the basic estimator of the population size is developed by Lincoln Peterson, and it is also very popular by knowing the name of Chandrasekhar and Devin. So later Chandrasekhar and Devin pointed out that this estimator is suffered from the bias. If there is a dependence between the two sources, then this estimator gives you an underestimate. Let us see what is the triple record system structure, data structure. So the earlier dual record system structure you can extend, and there is this person which are captured by three lists, and there are these person which are not captured by any of the three lists. So these people makes the X not not not. These are the people. So this unknown X not 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 makes your capital N unknown. So rest of all blue entries are known. So we have in triple record system, we have total 7 known cells and 1 unknown cells. And let's see, there are some existing models which deals with TRS data structure and also more than 3 data structure. There is a basic log linear model which assumes the Poisson distribution for the all the input. In the log linear model, we have 8 parameters, but the data are only 7. So there is estimability problem. That's why a common assumption is to assume the joint, the second order interaction U1 2 3 goes to 0. So if you assume this, then the log linear model gives these estimates. And further, if anyone additionally assume that, say, just U13 means interaction between first list and third list. So if if anyone assumes that there is no interaction between first list and third list, that means E13 equals to 0, then in addition to this assumption of E123 equals to 0, so then they will get these estimates. Problem is that in the MTB data structure, they only consider the 5 data entries, not the 3 equals to contingency table 7 data entries. So 5 data entries does not give them so much flexibility for the analysis. So that is the one problem. Another problem is that their all parameters are not identifiable and estimable. That's why the assumption in model MTB, they need some assumption to make the estimates and model estimates, but the assumptions are not justifiable in practice. So, and also in the log linear model, the parameters are not well interpretable. So there is a lag. So we work actually in this situation. We have modeled a new, we have created a new model called trivariate Bernoulli model, where we have modeled a triplet Y, Z, and W for each individual I, where the first Y denotes the capture status in the first list, the Z denotes the capture status in second list, and W denotes the capture status in third list. So this model actually encountered the dependence. Dependence means, just for example, we have categorized the whole population in 5 segments, and the first segment is there is some individuals who have a interaction between their first attempt and second attempt. There is some group of individuals who have interaction between their second attempt and third attempt, and similarly first attempt and third attempt, and obviously joint 3 second order attempts. That means all are interacted, all the sources are interacted for some people, and definitely the remaining people, that is called 1 minus alpha, where alpha is the sum of these 4. So these people are totally independent with respect to their capture probabilities, with respect to 3 sources. Okay, so let's see, this is the, and using this to estimate the model, we have assumed, for estimability just we have assumed, first time we have assumed alpha 3 equals to 0, and in another situation, in not time ordered fashion, when the sources are not time ordered, then we have assumed alpha 4 equals to 0. So there are 2 situations. And we have fitted this data to 2 real data sets. One is the malaria incidence in Netherlands, and another is the on the population of black males renters between this age in USA census coverage study. And we have shown that our method TBM1 and TBM2 have lowest AIC with respect to other existing models. See this, and also a smaller variance and the ACI means it is the asymptotic confidence interval. So our confidence interval also are relatively tighter. So this is the application of our model to these 2 real data sets. And we have done an extensive simulation study for the time constant. We have presented these 2 table only. We have studied, we have done the simulation model for different total 10 simulated population. For each of the population size, capital N equals to 400 and 1000. And then here we have seen the relative root mean square error of our method, TBM1 and TBM2, are very much smaller with respect to all other existing methods. You can see here 0.083 and 0.146 is much smaller than this relative root mean square error, and also our CIs are tighter than existing method. And if you see, the bias also very small. So this is one for the TBM1 model, this table, and the second table one for TBM2 model. Here also we have seen a remarkable improvement for our model, and I will conclude very quickly that we have seen that our proposed TBM trivariate Bernoulli model exhibits a remarkable improvement over the existing models. Our model possesses simpler in parameter interpretation, and it has identifiability and estimability over its rivals. And our model successfully encountered the three-factor interaction, which log-linear model can't do. And anyone can redefine the proposed model in order to incorporate the negative dependency. We have here considered only the positive dependency, so anyone can modify this. And at present, we are working on the extension of this model by including the heterogeneity between over the individuals, and the whole paper is, this presentation is just based on this. This is our paper from Journal of Royal Statistical Society, Series A. So this is the reference. Thank you, guys.